Alright guys, we're back staring at my engine bay, and in this video we're going to talk about what you need to do in order to safely run E85. And this is just like all my other E85 videos. I'm mostly making this because people haven't run E85 in the past, or you might have come from a platform that requires a lot of different parts and extra maintenance and things in order to safely run E85. So luckily our platform is pretty simple and easy to get going with E85. And I'm just going to explain that to you now so you kind of have the confidence you need in order to run it and you have good luck with it in the future. So the thing that you need to be aware of with E85 is it is more corrosive than gasoline. So while gasoline has pretty good properties that lubricate your fuel system, E85 is lacking those benefits. On older cars, it's very common to need to upgrade fuel lines and different components in your fuel system to safely handle E85. Otherwise, it can cause things to rot out and leak and just fail over time. Luckily, on the B58, we have a really high quality fuel system and everything is pretty much set up from the factory to run E85. I ran stage 1 E30. I know most people jump straight to stage 2 or stage 2 plus, but when boot mode first came out, and even now, I would say that stage 1 E30 is pretty much the best bang for your buck. You literally just flash the car, pump a little bit of spicy juice, and it's much faster. I actually ran stage 193 first, and then I went to stage 1 E30, felt a little bit of a bump, it was a little bit faster, and just all around a much more fun car to drive. So even on a completely stock system, no hardware replaced, you can run E30, just make sure that you're flashing the appropriate tune. Now while that does work, there are some things that you can do to make your life a little bit easier. Nowadays, the biggest thing that we're talking about are the flex fuel kits. What a flex fuel kit does is it installs in line with your fuel system to read how much ethanol is going to the engine, and it sends data back to the DME to adjust your tune appropriately. So the biggest issue that a lot of people have with running an ethanol map is they get their mix wrong, it causes the fuel pump to crash and all kinds of other issues. So making sure that you have a flex fuel kit installed on your car will eliminate any concern around that. If you ever get your mix wrong, or you're out in the middle of nowhere and you can't find ethanol and you need to just run pump gas really quick, you can do that and the car will automatically adjust without you having to flash, log, or anything like that. So it does make things really convenient. Again, not really needed, but it's a nice way to kind of foolproof running ethanol. Also keep in mind, a flex fuel kit is not the same as an ethanol analyzer. So the flex fuel kits that we have on the market are from Dorch and Bimmer ECU Solutions /MHD, as well as Boot Mode now has one as well. If you're running one of those, you'll wire it into the car, and that's how it actually controls how much your car is going to adjust for a specific ethanol content. Other analyzers like the Fuelit analyzer or the Spool analyzer, those are not flex fuel kits. The only thing that they do is send the ethanol content to your phone over Bluetooth. So it doesn't do any adjustments in the DME. It just allows you to see what's in the car and it can help you calculate your mixes. Even this isn't needed. You know, like I said, I ran stage 20/30 for a while. I calculated my mix at the pump every single time and never had any issues. But that does just give you a little bit of extra confidence. So when you're calculating your mix, you know what you're starting with. And then of course, other things that you can do are upgrading your fuel system with higher flowing components. So a bigger fuel pump, port injection, low pressure fuel pump, all of those things allow you to run more power with the same ethanol mix. And the issue is that ethanol isn't just more corrosive than gasoline, but it's also less energy dense. So if you run too much ethanol, it actually limits how much power the car can support. So upgrading your fuel system with higher flowing components will allow you to make even more power than you could on pump gas without the risk of your fuel system crashing. Now that's about it as far as making more power, but of course you want to make sure that you're doing your due diligence and keeping up with your maintenance as well. So something that I do is I flush the system with pump gas twice a year. Once in the middle of summer, like around July, I run a tank of 93 octane. And then also in the winter, I completely switch to 93 octane. Doing this will just make sure that the system is flushed and you're not letting old E85 sit and break down in your fuel tank or anywhere in your fuel system, so that you'll have, you know, the best luck and reliability over a long period of time. As far as running pump gas in winter, the reason why I do that is because, like I said, E85 has less energy than pump gas. And because of that, sometimes it can be very difficult to ignite the fuel in the middle of winter. So if it gets really cold where you are, it's a good idea to switch to E85. If you don't and you're running higher ethanol content, then sometimes you can run into situations where you have, you know, really long cranks, or worst case scenario, the car won't start at all because there's just not enough heat in the engine to ignite the fuel. So yeah, run one tank of 93 in the summer, at least one tank of 93 in the winter, if not all winter, and that should give you good reliability long term. The other thing that's recommended is to increase the frequency of your oil changes. The problem with E85 is it mixes with your oil. And a lot of people don't realize this, but your blow-by isn't just oil vapor. It also has some fuel. Basically, everything that's in the combustion chamber blows past the piston rings and mixes with the oil. And if it doesn't go out your PCV system and get recirculated to get burnt up, it will dilute your oil and cause it to break down. Fuel does that, but ethanol does it a lot faster. So that's why it's a good idea to increase the frequency of your oil changes, send it out for analysis, and just make sure that everything's good. So BMW recommends we do them once a year or about every 10,000 miles. In my car, I do it once a year, but it's because I only drive about 5,000 or 6,000 miles a year. And I actually sent my oil out for analysis last year. I posted up a video about it. And even though I ran full E85 for a period of time, for me, I found that there was no excessive fuel dilution in my oil. It hadn't broken down any, and there weren't really any issues with it. So I'm just going to stick with that same plan every about 5,000 or 6,000 miles. But for your specific situation, you'll want to do your own tests, send your oil out, and just make sure that you're doing the right frequency. I do feel like our oil that we run in our cars is very robust. We have really good, high-quality synthetic oils that don't break down as easily. And yeah, I think that pretty much sums it up. Again, E85 is a lot of fun. Just make sure you're doing your due diligence and paying attention to the system. If you do see anything wrong, if your car is misfiring, throwing codes, or whatever, address it. Don't just keep beating on the car, because that's when bad things happen. But our engines do a good job of handling it or telling you if something's wrong. And I think this is just a great platform to take advantage of E85. So yeah, that's it for this video. Thank you guys for watching, and I hope this helps. And if you have any other questions or comments, leave them down below.